Thanks for watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host. Today I have my friend Ray Yancey. Ray, I'm just going to have you live here. You can move in with us at BCA.
Yeah, I might as well.
Good
right?
to see you, my friend. Thanks
same
for being here.
Same here.
Mass Hire, Greater Brockton Workforce Board.
Right.
We're talking summer jobs.
Right.
Now it feels like it might be summer sometime in the month of May.
It depends on what day of the week.
Summer jobs start in July.
In July, actually.
But it's not too early to start talking about.
No.
So tell us what you got. I know we're talking youth from 16 to 21.
Yeah, 16 to 21. Mm-hmm. They need to go online if they're interested in doing the summer jobs.
Yeah.
They need to go online for YouthWorks at MassHire. GBWB.org.
Okay.
And then they'll find the application. It says young adults. Click on that, pull up the application, and do it online.
Mm-hmm.
Now, after they do that, there's two choices. They can either print off the application or just go down to YouthWorks.
Right.
And they'll print it off there.
34 School Street.
34
right?
School Street.
Right across lower from
level.
City Hall,
right.
Lower level.
Lower level.
That's the building
that
you guys own.
That's it.
Used to be a rental, used to be a bank.
Used to be a bank.
It was Rockland Trust, but way back.
Way, even before
Plymouth
that.
Home National
Plymouth
Bank.
Home. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And it turned into different incarnations.
I keep looking for some extra cash they left in the old safes, but I can't find it.
Funny you should say that. When we bought this building, all I found was one literally thin dime. It was a 1913 dime stuck up in a ceiling.
Is that right?
And we found a dance program because it had a dance hall on
it. Oh, yeah, okay.
Where it had the top floor back
yeah,
in the
right,
day.
Yeah, right, right.
But jobs, I mean, I've been looking. I see people posting jobs on that. Like right now, they're hiring up a Chick-fil-A. They're hiring up a Texas Roadhouse.
Yep.
They're hiring up the mall. Those are the type of jobs I have. But you guys have all sorts of other jobs, too.
Oh, yeah. We're looking at about 176 youth to put out there. So there's all kinds of jobs that they're putting them in. But the process has to go, with the application first.
Right.
Okay. They're going to go through training in the month of June.
Mm-hmm.
They'll have about 17 hours of training. Then they'll be able to go to work after the holiday, after July 4th.
Okay.
They'll be able to start work from the 5th
Which
on.
Which is good, because people want that. That's a weird week, the way July 4th falls. I think it's like either on a Wednesday or a Thursday,
something
like that.
In the middle
of
the week, so it's bad. Right.
You get an extra week of lead time in between
probably
school and work.
Yep, and then having the training and then get ready to go to work.
Right.
Now, they're going
to
work 125 hours for the whole summer.
Okay.
All right. Most cases are going to be making $12 an hour, which is like the minimum now.
Right.
You know,
right.
Sometime in August, they have 2 days where they're going to be in training again to complete the full training package.
Right.
But, you know, that's paid for, too. So.
But it's first come, first serve. You got
to
do it.
They got to do it.
They're, you know, you guys have been pretty good at getting the money to do the training, but there's been cutbacks over in years.
Yeah, right.
So jump on that.
Yeah,
because you don't want to be finding, you're sitting at July 20th with no job.
No job,
no spending money and a lot of time on your hands.
Right, exactly. And then, of course, we hope that, you know, wherever these youth are working, you know, we're hoping that the employers will look at hiring them after the summer.
Mm-hmm.
You know, give them another part-time job right after. So, you know, and that all depends on how they work. If they do a good job, there's a good chance they're going to get hired. So,
okay.
You know. But everything is going to be completed by the end of August.
Mm-hmm.
They'll be done working, and everything will be done.
Perfect.
So.
So if they want to call an old-fashioned phone number, what's that number?
508-584-9800. That's to YouthWorks.
YouthWorks, because it's different from the other number,
the
one that I've remembered since they've been in town.
Yeah, right.
Back
in
the day.
Right.
So are there any specific, I know you deal with other types of programs there.
Right.
Who's the, if they want to talk to an individual, talk to a person?
They can talk to David Vincent.
Okay.
He's the assistant director down in YouthWorks, and of course, Christelle is the director.
Right.
But anybody they call on, they'll be able to help them. Anybody answers the phone in YouthWorks, we'll be able to help them. So.
Okay. So you can either do it all online or come and walk in person and do it.
Right, exactly. So, and it's better. It's actually better that they start it online and then come down.
Okay.
All right. It's better it works out that
way. Everything's online.
Right. Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
And if you don't have your own online,
yeah.
you can go to the Brockton Public Library and go online.
And they can come in and just start the application
right
process
there
right there.
Right, exactly. So, okay. Yeah. So anything else, doesn't have to be YouthWorks, anything new at Mass Hire coming up? I know you're involved in all sorts of other things. We'll have you back. It's not like you're not ever going to come back here.
Oh, yeah, of course.
But we get about 4 more minutes. Yeah. I just want to
We're getting ready to close up our facility maintenance training that we started in April. Mm-hmm. Next Wednesday, they're going to graduate, and we'll have a speed networking event. We have 6 employers that are going to come in.
Yeah.
And me with the guys that are going to finish that class. Connecting with that, we have the welding program that just started last week.
Yeah.
And they're going till the middle of June. And that's just kicking off just well, you know, so.
And that one's South Shore Vocation.
That both right. is South Shore Vocation.
Okay. I just saw something coming up at Southeastern. They were doing 50% off the welding thing.
Oh, really?
And I was saying, you know, maybe I'll figure out how to fix that thing behind the building here and take up the welding myself. I don't know.
Yeah,
I don't
right,
know. It
right.
looks interesting.
Yeah.
So summer's a real busy time.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
There.
Right. And of course, you know, once the end of June comes around, we'll find out how much funding we have for the rest of the year.
Right.
And then we'll find out what other programs. You know, we have some things in the pipeline that we're looking at.
Yeah.
Usually we don't do anything during the summer because people want the time off. But starting the end of August, first part of September, we're hoping we do another healthcare training. Maybe do the next level, like, what do you call it, medical assisting.
Yeah, okay.
You know, maybe the next one. Who knows where it's going to go. But we're going to try some other things for next year, so. Mm-hmm. But we want to get them off because, I mean, we've done 13 CNA programs, mm-hmm. including the adult and the youth. We got actually the youth cohort is in there right now. That's number 13. So they've been very successful, you know.
Okay.
A lot of them have come out of there with their CNAs, which is what we're looking for. So.
Okay. Well, we'll follow up on it.
Yeah.
We'll, you know, when the summer jobs come, when it gets closer, when they have to apply by, is there any specific
no,
date?
No, they all I can say is do it now. Yeah, okay. Want them in by the beginning of June because that's when the training starts. So
they have to
have the application in and make sure they're qualified, and then they'll be okay for June.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah.
Well, Ray, thank you as always for coming in. I know you're pinch hitting today.
Yes,
I appreciate everything you do. You do a great job, and so does the whole organization.
Yeah, I'm just glad to be here.
Okay, thank you.
All right, thanks.
You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host. Stay tuned for more events, places, people, and faces right here in the City of Champions.